this elite book could not recover, even if I try or recovery option from Microsoft. So what I'm going to do now, I'm going to actually plug this one in one of the USBs, USB 3, and then I will run the diagnostic and show you what's happening.
This USB stick that you see contains software which I downloaded from HP, and this software allowed me to boot this HP laptop to hardware diagnostic mode and test the hardware.
Okay, now I'm going to actually start booting, and I'm pressing F2. Okay. And I will go now to the diagnostic, initialize diagnostic. You can see what's happening here. Okay, so now what I'm going to do, I'm going to go to component test, and I will test the hard drive, because that's the thing I'm actually definitely think is the problem. So whenever I test the hard drive before, it showed me okay, but it's not okay. Even if I run the check disk, he showed that everything is okay and everything is good with his hard drive. But let's diagnostic through HP. And I'm going to run a quick test. And I'm going to run it once. And let's see what happened. You can see here, I'll take it, leave it. You can see fail. So there is a failure here. And I asked HP regarding this failure in the hard drive, and they said to me, that's it, the hard drive is failed, it cannot be recovered. So what I want to show you here is, I want to show you now how to install a new driver. Prove that the hard drive is malfunction. So I'm going to replace it. In order to replace it, the first thing you have to remove is the battery. Okay, so it's the battery. You see this? Very easy to remove. Put it on the side. Okay, here in this area, sitting the hard drive. So I'm going to remove this hard drive. This hard drive is actually 500 gigabyte, and I'm going to replace it with a 1 terabyte hard drive. Now what you have is, you have two screws here. Let me show you. If I come from B, you can see this screw one, and the second screw is here. Okay, and you have to use a screwdriver like I'm doing here, and just loose. If you loose it, it's enough. The screw really stay here, and just unscrew it here. Okay, so what you're doing here, you just press it to the left. See, press it to the left, and the cover is going out, and you can see this is the hard drive, it's here, and this hard drive have to be replaced. So if you can see about these two screws are staying in the cover, don't remove it, then you won't find them forever. It's very small. However, you can see there is 4 screws. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4. All of them are Phillips screws. So what you need to do, you need to unscrew them with a screwdriver, simple screwdriver. Okay, so I will unscrew them now. So after you loose the screws, you just pull it. You pull this hard drive, and what you see here, there is 4 screws that stay on this cover, the handle or slab or whatever you call it. And there is another 4 screws here. 1, 2, 3, and 4. This one actually, it's missing. Probably the person who put it before didn't put it back, but we can get over it. Okay, so now what I'm going to do, I'm going to remove it, because my hard drive did not arrive with the slab. So before I'm going to take it, I just want to show you, there is a picture here, tell you how to do it, how to take it, how to remove And in addition to it, you see, this is the port that's going inside to the computer here. If I put it like that, you can see I can move it, and you can see it here. And this is the interface to the bus of these Elite Power. So you can see what's happening here. Interface, this is the company, it's AGST, that's HP working with this company. And I'm actually going to put a Seagate. So that's it. That is the all this issue here. So now I have to remove this plastic or cover by removing these four screws here. Actually, I have three screws only, but I need it because, oops, one of them fell down. Okay, I need to be very careful with these screws. It's kind of a weird plastic. Okay, I remove it with my hand because I'm afraid this screw will fall down. And you see, that's all. That's what you have here. And that is the hard drive that's gone wrong. So here is my new hard disk that I purchased from Seagate. And as you can see, it's very small. It's the same size. Okay, when you're actually replacing a hard drive, either upgrading or replacing a bad hard drive, just make sure that the size of the hard drive is okay. This is 7mm by 2.5 inch here. This is very important because, as you can see here, if I put a little bit thicker one, you won't be able to close this laptop PC. So it must be for that one 7mm and below. Okay, and this hard, this laptop PC can only handle one hard drive. And for $45 today, you get a 1 terabyte. For $60 or $70, you get a 2 terabyte. So it's like really cheap. And this one, old one, you can see it's probably look like 5-6 years on the road. It only have a 500 gigabyte, and I think Seagate is better quality than this one with HP. So I'm removing it. Okay, so that's the way it's look from here. And that's the way it looks from here. So as you can see, there is a difference here, okay? Quite a big difference. The difference is this in the interface. So you have to remove this interface here and put it here. Otherwise, you won't be able to connect it. Okay, so what I'm doing here, I'm just moving this interface and put it here. Okay, that's very important. It doesn't come with interface, so don't be in panic when you don't see it. Okay? So when you put the interface as a socket, you make sure it's fully inside. So as you can see here, where is the interface, there are 7 pin here and 14 pin here. Total is 21 pin. This pin will go inside this socket here. Okay, just what we need to do now, we just need to put it and press it in. That it will go inside and will stick inside properly. But before, we have to put this flimsy or whatever cover. This cover purpose is only to protect this area from debris and also to pull the hard drive out of its location. So that's all the purpose of this plastic. In addition to it, it tells you where to pull it. You have to pull it here, push it here. So only one way to do it is like here. You should never pull it like that. That's the way to put it. Okay? Now I'm going to put this very, very small screw, as you can see here in the location. So you really don't want to lose them because they're so small. Just close it firmly. Because remember, in 2 years, 3 years, you maybe need to take it out again, either to update it, or maybe it will crash. Who knows? Okay, so you see what you have now? This, you can pull it next time when it's going bad. So what we're going to do next, just to place this hard drive where it should be located. Remember, when you put it, you have to make sure it's actually pressed inside to the interface. Otherwise, all the pins should touch strongly the interface. Now this plastic is really weird because now it's actually going a little bit out, but I get over it because I'm going to press it in. Okay, so it pressed now, and now what I need to do is just close these four screws. So after the hard disk and this plastic cover is inside properly, okay, a little bit press it, you're going to just attach the screw properly. There are four screws to the place. Make sure this hard drive will not move ever. Make sure all of them are closed properly. You don't really want any movement here of the hard drive when you actually use your laptop. So this hard drive has to be stable inside, attached properly with four screws that it cannot move because this laptop is actually moving with you. This hard drive should stay still all the time. So this is almost the last thing to do here, is just to put the cover back. Okay, so I want to show you how you put it here. You just give it an offset to the left side and then you move it here and that's it. Now you have two screws here. You can see this screw and this screw. Okay, and the battery is the last thing to put. Let's put the battery here. The same thing, battery, you put it here and then you press it, but this one should be in red, and close it. And you have a new hard drive of a 1 terabyte
instead of 500 gigabyte,
which take 5 minutes to replace. The hard drive, you have to test to see if the thing working. So the first thing, I'm going to boot it like this and let's see what happened. So you see HP hardware diagnostics. Okay, it's coming. So I say exit and I will say sure. I say yes, I want to get out to see what's happening here. And as you can see, you can read it yourself. So as you know, this hard drive doesn't come with operating system. So what he asks you here, please install an operating system on your hard drive, hard disk. Okay. So that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to install it. But before I'm going to install it, I want to check the hard drive to see if it's okay. So remember, I'm using this program that I get from HP. And if you are working with Dell computer, or with hardware, they probably have their own hardware. Either it's already installed in the computer, or you can install it on a USB stick. So let's close it and check it again to see if our hard drive working, because remember I bought a hard drive from Amazon, it's a Seagate, and I want to see if it's working. Okay, so let's see if it's working. First thing I'm doing, I'm closing it. Second, I'm going to put the USB here, one of the port. Okay, and now what I'm going to do, I turn it on and press F2. Okay, when I press F2, you will go to diagnostics. I want to show you what's happening here. So now it's going to diagnostics, correct? Okay, when you go to diagnostics, I'm going to component test. Remember, what I'm interested in is the hard drive. So I'm going to the hard drive. Here is the hard drive. Okay, and I put Intel. And then I want quick test. And then I say runs once. And it start running. So I expect it now not to fail, because if it's failing, I'm going to return back to Amazon. But 99% when you buy Seagate, it's very reliable. So you trust them. So we almost finish. Okay, we finish, and you can see what he read. He say hard drive smart check pass, hard drive short DST check pass, component paste pass. I will continue testing it, a slow test, not a quick test. I'm going here. If I go back to main menu, I can say component test, and then I can go to the hard disk again, and then I can go to extensive test. There is also smart check and stuff like that, but if I can go to extensive test, this will run forever. So I will run it here once only to see what's happening. But as you know, the only thing that left now is to actually install the Windows operating system in this laptop PC. Thank you for watching this video.